The latest update that I know of is we're roughly about 43,000 acres and about 15% contained. That containment should go up tonight. We're looking at about between 200 and 250 personnel. So my job as incident commander, I work with the agency administrators, I work with either the BLM, the county commissioners, those types of people to get a delegation of authority, which gives us our marching orders, is basically the objectives of the incident, you know, which could be first and foremost, firefighter and public safety. We got a lot of big game habitat that we want to try to protect, as well as sharp-tailed grouse. You know, along with all the infrastructure and structures and residents, you know, that's within the fire's perimeter.
If things continue the way they are, do you anticipate a quick turnaround on this?
Yeah, I would estimate we're looking maybe 3 to 5 days. We're expecting a pretty big wind event this afternoon, starting about 1900, with possible gusts up to 40 miles an hour, which is not very favorable for the fire conditions where things are extremely dry right now. And so we're doing what we can to work the flanks and to try to pinch this off, you know, prior to the wind event taking place this evening. It's a mixed bag. It's very open. It's very rugged in some of these tighter drainages. And there are some intermixing ranches and farm ground, private property, as well as structures that are within very close proximity to the fire's edge.
Tomorrow morning, how many people do you expect to have on the ground?
You know, we're still probably going to run about the same, about 250 personnel for right now. And then we've got additional resources that have been ordered and should be arriving within the next, you know, 12 to 24 hours. So the head count should increase. And so we're going to continue doing suppression efforts to try to contain the fire on the northeast side, as well as the southeast side. And then once we start getting those things buttoned up, then we'll go into rehab.